The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Your big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place. Singing...
Hey everybody, Donald Whisman back again with another live Facebook video to support President Trump, folks. I'm wearing my George Lang shirt tonight. He's running for Ohio State Senate here in Ohio, 8th Congressional District. And if you don't know who I am, follow me on Facebook. And if you're watching this video in a replay, please, I ask you just, tap on the video and watch it. Open it up for 10, 20 seconds. That shows me how many people's actually watching my videos. So, hey, Maria Dukes, you're already in there. Hello, how you doing? Rob Christie, how you doing, Rob? Anyway, got a few things we'll talk about. Ted Smart, there's Grandpa. I'm starting to call Ted Smart. He's the older guy. He's like my grandpa. It's just a funny thing between me and Ted. Hey, Kim Martin, how you doing? Yeah, we'll talk about a few things going on tonight. I don't know if all you guys seen my videos from the day before yesterday. Yes, I went and I got to see President Trump, and it was awesome. It was awesome. I loved it, and we'll talk about that here in a little bit. But hey, Steve, how you doing? Steve, Jeff Shanks is in there. All right. Let's Kathy Cully Cope. How you doing, Kathy? Hope everything's going okay with you. Hope everything's going all right with everybody out there. Last Sunday night's video was a success, folks. We actually hit over 9,000 views Sunday night, so it was great. We had a great time. The video turned out great. I thank everybody for watching my video this past Sunday night. But Monday morning, I didn't want to tell you guys. I wanted to be a surprise that I was going to see President Trump, and I got really close to him this time. The thing about going to see President Trump is I've never seen Air Force One, and actually I was probably 50 foot, maybe a little further away when Air Force One pulled up. And I'll tell you, folks, if you've never seen Air Force One land, it's so patriotic knowing that that's carrying the leader of the free world, President Trump, and very, very patriotic thing to see, to watch your president land on Air Force One. It was so exciting. And I got after the little rally was over, Air Force One actually moved right in front of the hangar, so I turned around, I got a good shot of Air Force One. It's a beautiful, hey Floyd Croucher, how you doing? Air Force One was beautiful, folks. That's the first time I'd ever seen Air Force One. I've been to like 3 or 4 Trump rallies, but I've never seen Air Force One. I loved it. I loved watching Trump. I was so close. I actually got to see, I don't know if you guys know people's knuckles, but there's like little lines in your knuckles, and I was so close I could actually see the lines in his knuckles, and it was awesome. I've never really been that close to the president, and it was daylight, it was beautiful, had a really good, clear vision of President Trump, and like I said, I've been to 3, maybe 4 Trump rallies, but this one here, every one of them, they're an experience that you'll never forget. So if you get a chance to go see President Trump, go and see the president. It's you get tired. Trust me, you get tired. And I'll tell you guys, when they opened, we were standing out in front of this airport, and there was this gate that they let us in about 2:30, and I didn't know there was a half mile, quarter mile, maybe a half mile to get up to this hangar where we was going, and everybody started running, and I'm kind of fat, right? I got a long body and I got real short legs, and I couldn't keep up with him, so my friend Floyd, he got behind me and was kind of pushing me. So if you guys just could imagine that, this Floyd, he weighs like 100-some pounds. He's behind me, my body's laying back, and my little legs was just, I got short legs, and he was just pushing me. So I was leaning back, just, I was out of breath, I was panting. The police were all laughing. If you guys would have seen it, you would have laughed too. It was really funny. But President Trump, he gave a great speech day before yesterday. He gave a great speech. It was mostly he just talking. He didn't even go off the teleprompter. I mean, he went off the teleprompter basically the whole time, and he was funny. I know that he tried to say something about our governor here, Mike DeWine. Mike DeWine, our governor, was there, but he never showed his face to the public. And the president said, "What about your governor, Mike DeWine?" And the whole crowd said, "Boo!" And you know that had to be shameful for the governor to get booed like that by his own party. But you know, he's kind of like a rhino. This man has hurt a lot of small businesses in the state, and I don't blame the people for booing him. I don't blame him. Hey, Robert Hoskins, how you doing? Anyway, we'll talk about a few things here tonight. I don't know how long my battery will last on my phone. I didn't fully charge it. Actually, I've been volunteering all day for President Trump, and I'm tired, but it's worth it. I'll work 10, 12 hours if I have to help our president. And what I tell everybody, folks, is I'm volunteering for our grandchildren, my children, or my grandchildren, your children, your grandchildren, because if we don't get this president reelected, they're the one that's going to have to pay for it. Us older people, it'll affect us, but I just want my grandchildren to grow up and have the same freedoms I had. And if this weirdo Joe Biden somehow gets elected, and if he does, it'll be because he cheated. And I'm fighting against this. And believe it or not, there's a weirdo about two houses down from where I live. I came home tonight, and he had a Joe Biden flag. He already had some Joe Biden signs in his yard. Now I pull up. I came home tonight. Now I have to see this big Joe Biden flag flying two houses down from my house, and that goes against everything I stand for. And anybody that would put a Joe Biden flag up and signs in their yard, I don't think they know what's going on. I really don't think they know what they're voting for. This Joe Biden is going to destroy our country, and it makes me sick to see things like that. And you guys can start commenting if you want to. I'll read your comments. I love to read your guys' comments. That's why I come on here and I do these videos. I don't do them for me. I'm doing them for you guys, too. Hey, Tony, how you doing? Austin Merwin, how you doing, Austin? But, you guys, President Trump, he has every right as a president, as a sitting president, to nominate a Supreme Court justice. Now, we talked about this a little bit on Sunday night, and Nancy Pelosi, I guess she's threatening to impeach our president again if he decides to nominate a Supreme Court justice. Now, constitutionally, our president has every right to nominate a Supreme Court justice. And why wouldn't he? Why wouldn't he? Why would they even expect him not to nominate a Supreme Court justice? There is a vacancy, okay? These people, they stay in there for 20, 30 years. When there's a vacancy, you fill that vacancy. And Mitch McConnell, he thinks he's got the votes needed to confirm a nomination. Even Mitt Romney, I guess that he's going to vote in favor of Trump's nomination. So why wouldn't President Trump want to nominate a Supreme Court justice? Hey, Scott Waldrop, how you doing? My sister's on her. Hey, Melissa. But why? And the Democrats, they're having a temper tantrum because they're thinking President Trump's going to nominate another Supreme Court justice. Yes, Nancy Pelosi. Yes, President Trump is going to nominate a Supreme Court justice. I was just watching the news when I came home. He's going to announce it Saturday evening sometime. But and he's going to pick a woman. He's going to pick a woman. He's going to pick a good woman that knows the Constitution. That's what it's all about. And I don't even know why the Democrats wouldn't even go ahead and vote for her, too, because she'll probably be a great woman, right? But you got these Nancy Pelosi's and the rest of them. I talked about them. And every time I do these videos, I tell you how nasty and evil and disgusting and vile these... They're pure swamp creatures like President Trump. They're like lizards, snakes. They're like little snakes crawling around. Swamp creatures. That's what I call them, swamp creatures. And why wouldn't he? Why would they expect him not to nominate a Supreme Court justice? It's beyond me. Why would this man, our president, our great president... I mean, I know there's an election coming up here in what is it, 43, 44 days from now? I didn't actually look before I came on here. But it's getting close. This election's coming up, folks. And I'm telling you right now, we are getting people registered. I've never seen this many people getting registered as this year. People are registering. They're coming out of the woodworks. People that's in their 40s, 50s, 60s, they're coming out and registering. And I told you guys Sunday that everybody that's registering, I'm asking them, why are you registering this year? I know why they're registering, but I ask them anyway. And every one of them, excuse my language, but every one of them says they're tired of the bullshit. And I don't blame them, folks. I really don't blame these people for wanting to vote for President Trump. They are tired of the crap. I mean, I know, like, down in Louisville, Kentucky right now, I don't know how many of you have been keeping up with the Breonna Taylor story. You may have heard about it. You may have not down in Louisville. But I guess some of those police officers who shot that girl had to go to court today. And now they're calling a peaceful protest right now because it's daytime. But those peaceful protests, they normally turn into violent protests come nighttime because not only Black Lives Matter, but Antifa comes in and they start destroying buildings. They start setting things on fire. They start throwing bottles at police officers. So we can't have this anymore. We got to stop this nonsense. It's nonsense. These crazy people out there. That's not a good way to get your message across, by burning down cities. It's not a good way to tell the people that you're not happy. But the people, the American people, the good people of this country, we're fed up, folks. We're all fed up with what's going on. And hey, Jody Dittmeyer, how you doing? And you guys start commenting. Tell me how you feel. And the number, if anybody wants to call in, the number is pinned at the bottom of the comments right there. Hey, Kathy Leedy, how you doing? I'm glad you came on here, Kathy. Somebody please invite Carol O'Neill in. I hope she gets to come on here tonight. So let's try to get Carol in here. You guys invite your friends in. I don't care if they're liberals. Bring them in. I want to hear what they say. Tell me one liberal. I'd like to know a Democrat, if somebody's just voting, actually going to vote for Joe Biden. Give me a reason why you're voting for Joe Biden, other than the fact that you hate President Trump. And I want to know why they even hate President Trump. Sean Tucker, how you doing, man? Glad you came on here tonight. But I want to know why they hate our president. There's no reason to hate this man. This man is doing nothing but helping America, folks. And I'm tired of this crap. I'm to here. And I know, I think it's this coming Tuesday, we get our first presidential debate, and I can't wait. I can't wait. I want the Democrats. I want every Democrat in this country to watch that debate, because President Trump, you know, it's kind of like watching a Rocky movie. That's what it's going to be like. That first presidential debate is going to be like watching one of those Rocky movies, you know, where he boxes everybody. Trump's going to wipe the floor with Joe Biden. All right, I'm getting a call, so we'll take a phone call. Can I get your first name and where you're calling from?
I'm calling from Trenton, Ohio.
Hey, what's up from Trenton, Ohio?
We're having a Keep America Great rally here in Middletown, Ohio, on October 3rd at the old DAB, 6410 Trenton Franklin Road, okay. Middletown, Ohio.
I think I know who this is.
We like to invite all of our friends and all of our family that Trump supporters to come out and hear the endorsed GOP candidates and just have a good time and supporting our president.
I think I know who this is, but I'm not going to say your name, but I'm all for that. I can't wait. And I'll tell you what, I think I know who you are, but How many grassroots rallies have you seen for Joe Biden? I've not seen any.
I haven't seen zero.
And they say that Joe Biden is leading our president in the polls. That's a bunch of crap.
Yes, it is.
And, anything else you'd like to say from Trenton, Ohio?
Judge Jean Pirro for Supreme Court Justice.
Well, President Trump said that he's going to make his... He's going to let us all know Saturday evening who his pick is. But I think Justice Jeanine would be good. I think she'd be great. But the thing is about these Supreme Court justices, they try to get them a little young. That way they can stay 20, 30 years in the Supreme Court. You know what I'm saying?
Yes. Well, that leaves Pelosi out.
Well, Pelosi, I'll tell you what. I think she's on her way out. I hope she's on her way out. Kevin McCarthy, I think he's the minority leader in the House. He said if she tries to impeach our president, he's going to try to oust her. They're tired of her there in the U.S. House of Representatives. They're tired of her.
Yes. Well, the rally, doors open at 2. Go to the Butler County GOP, free tickets.
Alrighty.
Go under events.
Thank you. And I will be I will be sharing this on my page too about this rally. I'll be sharing it all over.
All right, hon. I'll talk to you later.
All right. Bye bye from Trenton, Ohio.
Thank you.
All righty. Trenton, Ohio is another little town. It sits about, 10 miles from where I live. It's a nice little Trump town. Basically, everybody in Trenton, they love President Trump. Middletown, I'm talking little cities around where I live, but I'll tell you, Ohio right now, you would not believe the grassroots rallies that are going on for President Trump in this state. Ohio loves President Trump. From what I'm hearing, Florida down there loves President Trump. I'm hearing from, a lot of people in different states, and when I was at the rally, when was it, day before yesterday, I met a lot of good people. I met a lot of good people, and get another phone call. Oh, hello, can I get your first name and where you're calling from?
My name is Floyd Croucher, and I'm calling from Trenton, Ohio. Donald Whisman, you're a great American.
Well, Floyd, you're a great American, too, and thank you for pushing me for a quarter of a mile, or I wouldn't have been able to make it to see the president.
Donald, we had a blast. I'm telling you what, it was such an honor for me and you to get to go and see our president, Donald J. Trump.
It was awesome.
It was our first time together getting to see him, but I'll tell you what, I will never, ever forget the experience we had.
You're right, brother. Neither will I. And you guys, this is Floyd. I call him Hurricane Floyd because this guy, he's got more energy than a Category 5 hurricane. He weighs 100-some pounds. I'm 300-some pounds. But he was pushing me. He was behind me, pushing on my back, and all of my little legs was doing to keep. I got short legs, and it was comical. But Floyd was pushing me. It was like he was a little train pushing the big fat, a big train full of coal, saying, I think I can, but he got me there. We made it there, didn't we, Floyd?
Yes, we did, and I'll tell you what, it was worth every moment of it.
Absolutely.
Donald, what I'm calling you about, I'm calling you tonight to ask people to get more involved in the campaign. If it's getting out and walking, if they're a person that likes to exercise, get to your GOP, wherever it's at in whatever county you're in, get some door hangers, get out there and do some walking, get your exercise, whatever it is you like to do. If you like to sit in an office and put bag signs together, whatever it is, go to that office and help them, volunteer to help them. If it's just putting a sign out for your local candidate, put it out in your yard, show your support for your people that you're standing for, which stands for Donald Trump and his agenda.
Well, that's good words from a good guy right there. Floyd is an all-American. He's a patriot. He loves his country. He loves his family. He loves God. And he's doing his best here in Butler County. Do what Floyd says. Get out there and get involved, folks. Get involved. Floyd, you want to say anything else?
Well, I was also wanting to touch the subject about the Supreme Court justice. Saturday, our president is going to come out with his person that he is picking, the lady he is picking for the Supreme Court justice. I feel we should fill that seat as quickly as possible and not hesitate like they want us to and make a big scandal out of it.
Yeah, why would they even expect him to wait to nominate a Supreme Court? They shouldn't even expect him to wait. We're going to get the votes in the Senate, and what they're doing right now, they're acting like a bunch of spoiled little brats in the House. These Democrats are. They're acting like spoiled little kids.
Well, it's actually that generation where they claim it takes a village to raise a child. No. It takes the parents to raise their own child, and it's the participation trophy group is what I call them.
Well, you're right. It takes a good father and a good mother to raise a child. Trust me, I raised two girls, and you can raise your kids right, but sometimes you got wild kids. I get it. Kids rebel sometimes, but there's a lot of kids out here right now protesting, and they don't even know why they're protesting, Floyd. They don't have a clue why they're protesting. They're just doing it.
Well, that's not protesting what I see on television. God gave me two eyes, and he gave me a brain for me to use. And what I'm seeing and what the media is saying is protesting is not protesting.
No.
That is rude. That is looting. That is rioting. That is burning down people's businesses. That is not protesting. Now,
no.
When people drive by, when me and you're out there putting up those big signs, and they flip up one finger saying, giving us California howdy and saying we're number one, we hold up four fingers, meaning four more years, and that's exactly what they don't want, and that's why they're trying to stop the Supreme Court justice from being filled.
Absolutely, absolutely, Floyd. Anything else you want to bring up while you're on the phone, Floyd? It's your turn, buddy. Speak now.
No, I want to give somebody else a chance. I really do want to give somebody else a chance. Donald, you're a great American. I appreciate what you're doing for our president and what you're doing for our local county as well. You're a hard worker going in a DOB office every day, sitting there dealing with people, multiple attitudes, multiple personalities. You're great at what you do, and we really do appreciate it.
Well, Floyd, if you noticed, I got my George Lang shirt on, folks. He's running for Senate here in the 8th Congressional District in Ohio. I know a lot of you guys ain't from Ohio, but in your state, get out here and help your local candidates. It's very important. And, Floyd, somebody else is trying to call in. So,
no problem. I'm going to give him a chance again. I encourage everybody to get involved with the campaign. Do your thing to help your candidates and our president get into office. Thank you very much, Donald. You have a good evening.
Floyd, I got your flag on down there waiting on you, okay, while you're on here. I got your flag. Bye, Floyd. That was Floyd. Great guy. He gets out here. He works hard for President Trump and the local candidates, and every one of you guys should do that, too. And I want to tell you guys a little story before we get another caller. Whoever's calling in, they hung up or something, but feel free to call. The number's down there below the comments. Feel free to call. Let me know anything. You can tell me anything you want to. I don't want any racial slurs or anything like that because I'm not a racist. Let's try to keep the cussing to a minimum if we can. I don't want to impede your freedom of speech, but I use little cuss words, but not big bad ones, okay? It just don't sound good. But anyway, the Democrats, they're going crazy right now. And I'm going to tell you a little story what happened today. I was down here today volunteering in a Trump Victory Center. It's a brand new Victory Center. They just opened up in, about 10 days ago, and this old couple came in this morning, and they got them a couple of Trump yard signs, and they looked at me, and they said, we're scared to walk out to our car to get back in our car. So I walked them to their car, and get out and do stuff like that. I mean, because some of these old people, they're really afraid out here right now because these Democrats, they've gone nuts, and they've got a lot of old people really scared. And can you imagine if they were scared to walk out of a Trump Victory Center to get in their car? Can you imagine on Election Day if how scared they're going to be to go vote at these polls in some of these big cities? So that shouldn't happen in this country. Nobody in this country should have to fear for going to vote. Nobody should have to be in fear. And that's what the Democratic Party has caused. They've caused fear in this country. Nobody should have to be afraid to go vote. Nobody should have to be afraid to put a Trump sign in their yard. Nobody should have to be afraid to put a Trump bumper sticker on their car. But that's what's happened here in the country, this country, because the Democrats, that's what they want. They want to instill fear in this country. They want to divide us as a nation. And I'm telling you guys, it's bad. It's really bad. And the only way we can stop it is it'll stop when we reelect President Trump. This madness will stop because there's nothing they can do. He's going to serve his last 4 years, his second term, and I don't know what else to say. We got to reelect this president. Our children and our grandchildren's futures depend on this election, and I hope in 2024, maybe we can get another Trump to run, maybe Donald Jr. run, maybe Ivanka run, maybe we can get somebody that will energize us like President Trump has energized us all, and he really has. You know, I've always been proud to be an American. Trust me, I've flown the American flag since I've moved out of my mom's house. But and I taught my kids to fly the American flag. But what happens? And 4 years from now, we got to get another. You know what? Let's skip that. I don't even want to talk about 4 years from now. We got to worry what's going to happen November 3rd. I've got another phone call. If I can get it to answer here. Hello, can I get your first name and where you're calling from?
This is Austin from Franklin, Ohio.
Hey, Austin, what's on your mind tonight, brother?
Not much. I just want to say, man, thank you for everything you are doing for President Trump. You know, me being a younger guy, we need the younger generation to hop on board. That's the biggest concern I have. You know, I never been into politics, but now I am, and we need President Trump to win.
Well, Austin, can I ask you a question? Why did you get into politics this year? What made you want to get involved in politics this year?
You know, I'm like I said, I'm a younger guy. I see what's going on out there. I see what the Democrats are doing, and they want to split us up. This whole race thing that's going on, the whole Black Lives Matter, that's fine. You know, I respect what some of what they're doing, the peaceful protest. But when it comes to the Antifa and all that, that's got to stop. And I finally opened my eyes and seen what's going on. And, you know, we as Americans, we cannot do that. And if we have Joe Biden in office, I believe that the whole country will go down fast.
Oh, Austin, let me tell you something here. Right out of Joe Biden's mouth, I'll tell you, Austin, I don't know how old you are. I assume you're in your 20s since you say you're young.
I'm 27.
Okay, well, I'm 51. I'm old enough to be your dad, okay? I can't tell you what to do because I'm not your dad. But these Democrats, they've been pretty mean for a long time. They've been really nasty. They've done a 360. They used to be, when I was growing up, I was always taught that the Democrats were for the poor and the working people, but they're not. These are the rich elitist, and we know President Trump was a billionaire before we elected him, but this is going to be the only president that went in the White House and is going to come out of the White House with less money than he had when he went in. This president doesn't even accept his salary. He donates it. I just can't tell you how many good things this president has done for this country and is going to do for this country, but he needs another 4 years, Austin. He really does. I'm glad you're stepping up. And I want you to talk to all the people your age. Get them involved. Get them registered, because a lot of them are not registered to vote.
That is very true. I've been on the ground. I measure for flooring around all of Ohio. Drive every day, and I always see younger guys, women, men, and I talk to them, and I try to get them to vote. We need it more than ever. You know, me being younger, you know, down the road, I'm going to have kids and a family. I want it to be great here in America.
Well,
and I don't believe that will be the case if Biden wins.
No, no. And when you have children, Austin, you want them to be free. You want your children to be free like you have been your whole 27 years of life, Austin. And you want them to die free, too, okay? They don't have a clue what socialism and communism is about. Joe Biden's going to give amnesty to over 11 million people when he becomes president. He will open those borders up. He will flood this country. And people like you, Austin, you won't find a job. You will not find a job when he opens them borders up. I'm telling you.
That's the truth. That is the truth.
And it's not fair to reward an illegal alien when you got hundreds of thousands of them that had to come here the right way. They come here, you know, it takes a lot of work to become a U.S. citizen. So it's not fair to the ones that came here the right way, the ones that love this country. Why are you going to reward somebody who broke the law? I don't understand that.
I don't understand. That's why, you know, I go back to what you were saying in the video earlier about having, you know, they lie and all the media and all that, man. It's unbelievable, and I really do want to talk. I've never talked to one yet, but I do want to talk to someone that, you know, like a straight Democrat or liberal. I want to talk to them and ask them why. Why are you voting for Biden? I just want a real reason. And I've talked, you know, I've heard of people that talk to some, and they always just say, you know, they hate Trump how bad he's been doing, and they don't see the facts. I wish people would have, you know, the facts of each one, the policies of each president. I think that's the problem with the younger generation. I really do, Donald.
Well, I'll tell you what, Austin, we got the first presidential debate coming up this coming Tuesday, and that'll give these Democrats, I hope every one of them are watching that, because President Trump is going to, he's going to show the world how stupid Joe Biden is. And I can't wait. I would pay money. I can't wait until the first debate. And everybody out there,
I
we
can't
need
either.
Yes, it's going to be great, Austin. And anything else you'd like to say, Austin, as a young
That's
American?
That's it. Just one more little thing for the fake media, you know. I have family all in Michigan, okay? I'm from Michigan. I live in Franklin now, but I'm from there. And I will tell you, I talk to them all the time. I say, what does it look like on the ground there? And the media will lie. It is not Democratic. It is all Trump.
Good.
So good. We'll win Michigan.
He needs Michigan. I'm glad to hear that. Thank you, Austin. I appreciate that. And,
yes, sir.
Come back down to the Middletown Bakery Center and see us again, Austin, all right?
Yeah, I'll have to stop by. I was by there today. I was a little rushed, but I'll stop in soon.
All right. Thank you, Austin. Thank you for calling in. I appreciate you watching my videos, brother. Thank you.
All right. God bless.
All right. Bye-bye. Actually, folks, I'm using my wife's phone here. I don't even know how to use her phone. It's different from mine. But, they're going crazy, folks. Then they are. But it's especially, I can't believe that Mitt Romney is actually coming out and, He's trying to act like a Republican finally, and I'm shocked. And once President Trump does nominate somebody Saturday, it don't take him that long. If Mitch McConnell's got enough votes, and if it's a tie, in which it ain't going to be a tie, all he needs is 51 votes, right? But there's 100 senators. You only need one vote to win to confirm a Supreme Court justice. But if it's a tie, Mike Pence is a tiebreaker. So they know, the Democrats know that President Trump's nomination will go through the Senate. They know that. And it's scaring them to death. It's scaring them to death. And I'm going to tell you why it's scaring them to death. They love abortion, okay? Most of these Democrats, I'm going to say 99% of them, they're all for abortion, folks. And I've seen pictures of these abortions, these late-term abortions, and it makes my stomach hurt. It really does. It saddens me to see these little babies, what they look like. These are human beings. And if you put a Joe Biden sign in your yard, or you're flying that Joe Biden sign, you're just as guilty as them. You are voting. And when you vote for Joe Biden, you're voting for abortion. So think about that for a minute. These Democrats, not you guys, but these Democrats need to think about, they need to stop and think. You know, God may judge you too for voting for somebody like that. If these people out here voting for that, they're just as guilty as the one committing the abortions, because you voted to let that happen. And it's really gotten bad. This abortion stuff, it's gotten bad. Roe v. Wade needs to be overturned. And if President Trump can nominate one more Supreme Court justice, that'll be 6 conservatives to 3 Democrat judges. Now, Justice Roberts has been leaning to the left lately. Okay, he kind of worries me a little bit, but we do have an opportunity here to get Roe v. Wade overturned, and I think this is the greatest thing. I don't celebrate anybody's death. Ruth Bader Ginsburg, yeah, she did a lot for women's rights, but she was also a number one champion for abortion, folks, and she's going to have to deal with God on that. I'm not nobody's judge. She's probably already up here talking to God. I wouldn't want to be in her shoes right now. She was 87 years old, and she was for killing babies, okay? That's what abortion is. It's just it's a nice word for murder. That's what abortion is. And I really don't want to talk sad tonight. Let's try to be a little bit happier. I'm just happy that I truly believe, I haven't been saying it a lot, but I truly believe President Trump is going to win this election. But I don't want to take it for granted, because I'm going to keep fighting. I'm going to keep fighting right up until Election Day like he's losing this election. But I'm just one guy, and I know you guys are doing your part. Believe me, I'm not sitting here saying you're not doing your part, but I'm telling you, I'm doing it every day. And I know a lot of you got to work out there. I'm not working right now. I had cancer. It put my legs out. That's why that guy Floyd had to shove me. My legs, I don't even have feeling in my feet. I could step on a nail, and I wouldn't even know it went through my foot. But I worked most of my life. I worked almost 30 years. I've been a hard-working guy my whole life. I've never even hit a middle class. I think I've always stayed in the upper poverty level. But you know what? I don't. Money is not a big thing to me. It's not about money to me. As long as I'm happy, my kids are healthy, my grandboys are healthy, I'm a rich man. When my kids are healthy, my grandkids are healthy, that makes me a rich man in my book. I'm rich even though I'm not rich, okay, because of my children. I love my children. I love my grandchildren. I would give my life right now for any of them. And I know every one of you guys feel the same way out there. You do, and I know you do. But start writing your comments, folks. Come on, let's see some comments. Let's see some likes. Invite your friends in. I don't even care if they're Democrats. Bring them in here. But they're hard-headed, folks. They won't listen. I've tried. I used to try to argue with these people, but it just don't do any good because they don't listen. Their heads have to be 3 inches thick, and their ears are clogged. We're getting another call, so we'll take it. And, hello, can I get your first name and where you're calling from?
Hi, Don. It's Kathy Leedy. How are you?
Well, what's up, Kathy? I'm glad to hear from you.
Oh, I'm doing okay. Hey, first off, I want to thank you so very, very much.
What for?
For showing us the video live. It was so emotional and so wonderful, and I am so thankful for you doing that. I know it wasn't easy on you. It wasn't easy on your back. I thank Floyd for pushing you to get you there. Because I'm going to tell you what, it was fantastic. It was so emotional and so nice. And you know what was really great?
What's
you
that?
Didn't see one riot. You didn't see any fighting. You didn't see any carrying on. Everybody was very respectful. Everybody enjoyed it. Everybody was thrilled to death to see him. And I thought, you know what? This is fantastic.
Well, I don't know, Kathy, have you ever been to a Trump rally? Have you ever been to one?
No, I would love to, but no, I have not.
You know what? If I ever get another chance, Kathy Leedy, I'm going to make sure you get to go to a Trump rally, if I can. If I have anything to do with it, you're going to go to a Trump rally, if I can. I can't promise you, okay? I can't promise anything, but if I ever get a chance, I'll get you to a Trump rally, okay?
Okay, I was truly loving it. I'll tell you what, I had my own little rally last night on my porch. Well, my neighbor.
That's awesome.
And we were just talking, and her daughter came over, too. And she's for Biden. And I said, that's fine. I said, that's your choice. I said, but can you tell me why? She says, I hate Trump. I said, okay, you don't have to like him. I said, I know what you're sitting there thinking. I said, he's arrogant. He's loud. I said, he doesn't care what people think. I said, he is there to fight for us, not for any other reason. He is not in there to be liked. He doesn't care if you like him or not.
I didn't vote for him to be nice, Kathy. I didn't vote for President Trump to be a nice man. No,
I didn't either.
I voted for him to get this country back on track, and he did that, Kathy. He kept his promises to the American people.
Yes, he did. And what I told her, I said, okay, here's the deal. I said, you don't like Trump because he says things you don't like. She was correct. I said, okay, that's like a parent trying to be a friend to a kid. I said, if you want to be a friend to your kid, trust me, they're going to be out of control. I said, Trump doesn't want us all as his friends. I said, he wants to protect us. He wants to work hard for us. I said, and the only reason that you're truly voting for Biden is because I think you were raised Democrat. She goes, oh, I was. I said, exactly.
Yeah,
I said,
you
okay, times have changed.
You know,
times have changed.
You're right. And I'm not going to mention anybody's name, but I've got in-laws. They're related to my wife. And they're all, there's a lot of them, that two or three of them are Democrat. And you know why they say they're voting for Democrat? Because they said their dad was a Democrat. And their dad's dead. But if their dad was alive, I guarantee you he'd be voting for President Trump this year.
Exactly. I agree with you 100%. And I told her, she said, well, you don't understand. He's going to cut everybody Social Security. I said, wait a minute. Whoa,
no,
back up.
That's a lie.
I said, the one who wants to get rid of Social Security is Biden.
Yes.
I said, I'm going to tell you something. I said, when's the last time you got a raise? I said, you got a raise in Social Security when Trump got in there, didn't you? I said, he's not going to take your Social Security. I said, he's going to fight for you to keep your Social Security. He's going to fight for our veterans. He's going to fight for our soldiers. He's going to fight for the United States. I said, he's going to want USA to be strong. I said, he wants people to unite. He does not want to separate us. He is not going on there and saying black this or white that or whatever. I said, he is trying to unite everyone.
Well,
I said, he's not trying to separate.
I will tell you something right now about the Social Security thing there. If Biden gets elected, which let's just pray he doesn't, I don't think he's going to, but listen, there's a lot of things the Democratic Party wants to do, and I don't know who's going to pay for it. For first of all, Kathy, they want to give everybody free health care, number one, right? They want to give everybody a free college tuition, right? They want to keep Obamacare, which is killing some people, this Obamacare. They want to do this new Green Deal. Where do you think that money is going to come from? They're going to steal that right out of Social Security. There is no money. The government's broke. We're 20-some trillion dollars in debt, and they're wanting to give. They're telling everybody you're going to get all these free things, but who's going to pay for that? Your children and grandchildren are going to pay that bill for these Democrats.
Exactly, and I tried to explain that to her. I said there is nothing free in this world, except for us right now. We have our freedom, but if you vote for Biden, you're going to lose that too.
Now,
and I told her, I said, here's the deal. I said, with Obamacare, when he made everybody get Obamacare, and I hope I'm correct when I say this, if I remember right, if you did not get it, if you did not have it, they fined you.
It was a mandate. Okay, that was a mandate, and that's a form of communism when the government mandates something on you, and they was penalizing you on your tax returns if you did not have insurance.
Exactly. Now,
Trump got rid of
that.
Trump got rid of that mandate on there.
He sure did, and I'm glad he did. And I'm going to tell you something. Everybody needs to wake up before it's too late. And they need to really, truly do the research between Biden and Trump. And they would open their own eyes. I mean, I try all I can. I sit and I preach it to them, and I try to tell them. But I said, you can't just do it because you don't like him.
No, it's not about liking.
It's
about this country. It's about keeping us free. It's about that flag. Trump really respects that flag. It's about so many things. And until this Hong Kong flu come along, look at the economy this president had. So what they do? They try to destroy the economy, but it's coming back. It's coming back, Kathy.
Yes, yes, it is. Well, that's like I fly my Trump flag, and I fly my American flag. And she said, well, I see you're flying your Trump flag proud. I said, yes, I am. I said, I'm going to tell you something. I said, I'll do whatever I got to do to get to that poll to vote. I said, because I am making sure that Trump gets in. I said, this is crazy. I said, we can't let this go on. I told her, I'm not worried about us as much. I said, but what about the young kids? What about the babies? What about your grandbaby? She has grandbabies. I said, and here you are. I said, you say you're a very religious person, which is fine. I said, but you're okay with Biden and this abortion and everything. She said, I'm pro-abortion. I said, late-term abortion? I said, I'm not talking the abortions they did 25 years ago. I said, the abortions today that they're willing to do?
It's horrible.
I said, there's morning after pills. There's a toy you can go get. Why would you have to wait long enough for it to be a baby?
Well,
to decide, okay, I want to have an abortion. I said, abortion was not meant for birth control.
You're right. Don't use abortion as birth control, but this is the year 2020. Listen, Kathy, there's so many options other than abortion. I mean, women can get fixed. They can get their tubes tied. Men can get a vasectomy. There's all kinds of different ways not to get pregnant. And, when you tangle like that, and little kids do, little young kids, they make mistakes. I get that. I get it.
Right.
I know.
Right.
But don't use – it's just awful. Abortion's awful. It's murder. We should get rid of our country. And, Kathy, I want to apologize to you because I didn't get the whole – excuse me. I didn't get the whole Trump speech on video because – when you're standing and you're trying to hold that phone, it kills your back trying to keep that phone straight. And it's really a strain on your back sitting there, standing there, trying to film when you got people behind you wanting to see the president. And I'm tall, and I'm blocking their view. I'm trying to stay out of their way. I'm trying to be nice. We all, at a Trump rally, everybody's really nice to each other. And you're right, they're all nice to each other. It's like we're all patriots. We're all patriots, and it's great. A Trump rally is great, and I want to apologize to you because I didn't get the whole speech on video live.
Didn't matter. What you got was fantastic. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I truly appreciated it. And I'll tell you what, we need to get you a tripod or one of them sticks that you put your phone on.
Well,
we need to get you something like that.
When you go to a Trump rally, when you go through that Secret Service makes you go through a metal detector, they take your lighters. You're not allowed to have a lighter. You can't have no tripods. So I did. I smuggled in a book of matches. Yeah, I'm a bad guy. I smuggled in a book of matches in my wallet. And there was actually no smoking back there, but I did find a porta potty. And I did smoke a cigarette really fast before President Trump got there in the porta potty. So I felt like I was breaking the law or something, but I did sneak a cigarette in.
Did you feel like kids in school again, Don?
Yeah, I got suspended a lot when I was a kid because I smoked in the boys' room. You remember the song Smoking in the Boys'
Room?
Yes,
I sure do. I smoked in the ladies' room if I remember that shit.
And back in the day, they would suspend you, but they didn't realize that kids, back in them days, I was kind of a punk kid, I don't know, but suspension was a reward. We didn't want to be in school, you know?
Exactly. That's how I was, too, because, I mean, I was just a brat. But I didn't take no crap. I'm not a follower. I don't like being told what I got to do. You ask me to do something, I'll do it. I'll bend over backwards to do it. But don't tell me I can't, and don't tell me I have to.
Right.
Because those are two things that's going to bring it out in me.
Well, I'll tell you what. If you vote for Joe Biden, not you, but any of these people in this country votes for Joe Biden, you're going to be told what to do. You're not even going to be able to watch what you want to on TV. If we become a communist country, they even control it. It's called state TV. You watch what the government wants you to watch. The government controls everything. And these kids don't understand communism. And it just makes me mad. They don't want to know American history, the real American history. They're not teaching it in schools anymore. They're not teaching our kids values, respect, morals. They're not teaching that. And it makes me mad.
No, I know it. And I'm going to tell you something else. Like the neighbor was saying, well, I went to Walmart. And they had a sign, or Sam's Club, I don't know, one of them. But she says, they have a sign on their door, you will not get your change, that they want you to use a card or whatever, or you donate the money. I said, let me tell you something, I'm not going to leave there without my change. I said, the one that's illegal to do, they can ask you if you'd like to donate it to whatever, and that's your choice, whether you choose to or you don't. I said, and she said, well, there's a coin shortage. I said, there's a really, I said, come on,
there's no coin shortage. That's just a bunch of crap.
That's all it is. I said, let me tell you something. Like, I won't wear a mask. The only time I do is when I take my mother into the hospital, because you have to. Okay, that's fine. I'll wear the damn thing then. But when I go in Walmart and stuff, I walk right through. And I'm going to tell you something. I'm not going to do it. I'm nobody's little lamb. My name is not Mary. I do not have a little lamb. I am not going to follow that little lamb. It's just not going to happen. And I told people, I said, you have a brain. Sooner or later, common sense has to kick in. But it doesn't.
They don't care. And there's so many people in this country right now that's not even registered to vote. And if you don't register to vote and you're vouching your opinion, your opinion means nothing to me if you're not a registered voter. I'm sorry, but I draw the line on that. That voting is a patriotic thing to do. And like the Electoral College vote, so the Democrats lose to the Electoral College vote. So what do they want now? Oh, we want to go with the popular vote. We want to go with popular vote. But there's never been a president in this country elected. Every president has been elected through the Electoral College because they don't want California, New York, they don't want them big states to decide the election. That's why our founding fathers set it up like that.
Yeah, exactly. That's like Facebook. We have no freedom of speech on there. You cannot say anything about a rioter. You cannot say anything on Facebook. Well, you know I have a new one already. And I already got smacked once. And it's like, are you serious?
I've been lucky lately. Back 2 or 3 years ago, I used to stay in Facebook jail, but I've been lucky lately. I kind of watch what I say, and people need to start commenting. Leave your comments. I'll read your comments, too. Trust me, I'll read them. Start commenting.
Yeah.
And Kathy, tell them to call in. Tell them.
Start commenting and call in. Call in, people. Let's hear what you have to say. Let's have a good time tonight.
Right.
I'm going to finish my cigarette and watch on and listen to everybody's comment, watch everybody's comments, and listen to their phone calls. Let's have a good night and dawn again. Thank you so very much. I told Linda, get the Bengay and the heating pad ready. Dawn's going to need it.
I seen that comment. I seen it, and my wife seen it, too.
Yeah, I seen that.
That was fun.
But I just wanted to thank you again, and you take care, and thanks for all you do.
Well, thank you, Kathy. I'm no more patriotic than you are, okay? I just happen to be, I'm like kind of like Forrest Gump. I just happen to be at the right time at the right place, I guess. I don't know.
Hey, I'm thankful for it. I enjoyed every minute of it. But you take care, and everybody call in, say hi to Dawn. And I'll talk to you later, Dawn. Have a good night.
Thank you, Kathy. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, folks. That's Kathy Lady. She lives somewhere up in northern Ohio. I've never asked her what town she lives in, but yeah. Start putting the comments up here. I'll read your comments. I'll mention your name. And again, call in. The number's at the bottom of the comments. Call me and let me know what you think about what's going on right now. Because the Democrats think President Trump's crazy for trying to nominate a Supreme Court justice and I think it's stupid. It's so stupid how they're acting. But they're, like I said, they're afraid that they're going to get in there and they're going to reverse Roe v. Wade, which is something you guys know how I feel. I'll get off that subject because sometimes I get teared up when I think about abortion. It tears me up. Folks, I don't go to church regularly, but I do believe in God. Those are angels. Those are little angels. They're just unborn children. And I don't even know how a Democrat could say they're a Christian. How could any Democrat that votes for Democrats claim that they're a Christian? They go to church, but I'm a Christian. I vote for Joe Biden, Hillary Clinton, or whoever. How in the hell can you be a Christian when you condone abortion? I don't get it. The Democratic Party, they're so un-American anymore. They're not American. Folks, we fought two wars. Don't forget about Korea. Don't forget about Vietnam. Do you guys remember why we went to Korea? Why we went to Vietnam? I'll tell you why. And you guys already know. We went there and so many men lost their lives to stop the spread of communism. And never did them guys probably ever think that one day here in this country we would actually be having an election between capitalism and communism, folks. And it is. We're a capitalistic country. We're a republic. These Democrats, they want to change that. They don't want us to be a capitalistic country. They're going to start out soft with communism or socialism, and it'll be full-out communism before it's over if you vote for a Democrat. And I could go on and on about all the bad things that's going to happen in this country, but I don't want to scare you tonight. I know what's going to happen, and don't worry about the rioting. If President Trump gets reelected, all these riots and these lootings, that'll stop an hour after the man's elected. Trust me, he can't do it right now. There's an election. I don't know, what is it, 44, 43 days, something like that. And folks, I'm telling you, come November 3rd, if we don't get out here and reelect President Trump, there won't be a redo. There won't be a redo. But what scares me right now is some of these states have already made it a law where they're going to be sending out millions and millions of ballots to people that have died, people that have moved. I don't know, there are going to be so many dead Republicans vote for Democrats this year. And that's what's scaring me. The only way the Democratic Party or Joe Biden and Kamala Harris is going to win this election is if they cheat. That's the only way they're going to win this election is by cheating. So we got to get out of here. We got to vote so much that all the votes, all their cheating in the country, we got to outvote the cheaters, okay? And it's a shame that the United States, the people of this country, can't go out here and vote without being scared. And that's not right. I mean, there'll probably be these groups of people in these big cities standing in front of all these voting locations. And that's wrong, you guys. You guys know that's wrong. It's wrong. It shouldn't happen. Everybody should have a chance to vote without fear that something's going to happen to them. And they're bad people, folks. And it is. There's a lot of scared people out there right now. And another guy told me tonight that he's just scared to put a bumper sticker on his car. He's afraid to put a Trump sign in his yard. And I don't get it. But I do get it because the Democrats have gone crazy and people are stealing our Trump signs. These people, you know, I don't like the Biden signs right down the street from my house. I don't like that. I hate that. I hate that. The guy put a Biden flag up tonight. I came home. This is two houses down from me. I came home and there's a big old Biden flag flopping in the wind. I'm thinking, oh my gosh. Here I put in probably 9 hours today that are volunteering my time for President Trump, which it's worth every minute of it. It's worth it, okay? But I have to come home and I have to pass that Joe Biden flag. I have to pass them Joe Biden signs that stands for everything that I'm fighting against. And it's sick. It sickens me to death. But what am I going to do? I'm not going to go there and steal the man's signs. But they sure steal ours, don't they? They steal ours. They don't care what we do. They're mean people, folks. They hate us. They hate us for voting for this good president. And you guys start commenting. There's 33 of you in here right now. Leave some comments. If you want to call in, the number's at the bottom of the comments. Call in. Somebody else call in. Don't be afraid to call. And I'll tell you another thing. These videos that I'm doing like this right now, I'm going to try to stay on here for an hour if I can, maybe a little longer. But these videos that I'm doing is being aired on Armed Radio. It's an internet radio station that gets broadcast in 66 different countries around the world. So, let your voice be heard here tonight. Call me and tell me what you're mad about. Tell me what you're glad about. Tell me about your state. Tell me how many signs you're seeing. How many Trump signs you're seeing. How many Biden signs you're seeing. If you're a Democrat, call me up and you give me one reason that you're not voting for President Trump other than the fact that you hate him. I don't want to hear that you hate him. Tell me why you're voting for Joe Biden, because I damn sure don't know why anybody would be voting for that man. Why would anybody in their right mind consider even thinking about voting for Joe Biden? It's just completely nuts. It's nuts, folks. I don't get it. I don't get it. I think these people have been brainwashed by CNN and these other fake news. I think fake news should be banned. It should be outlawed. We need to hear the truth. And I've been watching Newsmax a lot lately. I have. And folks, I've been getting invited to so many Trump rallies, I can't keep up with all of them. But I am going to my friend Floyd. He's got a big rally going on up in Trenton, Ohio. I'm going to attend that one. I'll help him out every way I can. Like I said, Floyd's a patriot. I know you guys are patriots too, but call me up. Call me up at the numbers at the bottom. I'll wait on you to call, okay? I don't know what else really to tell you guys other than we gotta reelect President Trump. That's it. If you guys know somebody who needs to be registered, please take them. Take them and make sure they get registered. Make sure they go vote on Election Day, okay? It's important. It's very important. If you love your children, do what you can for this president, because this president will save their future for the generations to come. And I'm telling you, if Biden gets elected, there will never, ever be another Republican president in this country. We'll never see another one. Even if we get the Supreme Court justices all in there, we'll never see another Republican president, folks. This country will be done. We'll be done as a free nation. We'll lose our rights. And I know the Second Amendment's a big right. We don't want to lose that. We will lose that. But the main thing is we'll probably lose our First Amendment. That's the freedom of speech. And once they take your speech away, like they're trying that now. They're trying to, like, on Facebook and these other social medias, they're already attacking our freedom of speech, folks. Even God himself's under attack. Our flag's under attack. Our national anthem is under attack. So that's why I do these videos. I do, and I don't even know if you guys are commenting. I'm not seeing them. I'm not seeing any comments come up here. All I'm seeing is who's watching, and if you're commenting, I'm not seeing them. So I apologize if you're commenting, because I'm not seeing them. Let me do this for a minute, and I'll bring them back. Maybe now. Now I'm seeing them. I had to scroll over. So hey, Maria Dukes, Trump 2020. All right, I'm seeing your comments now, folks. All right, I got another call coming in. Let me try to reach this phone. Here, this phone. Hello, can I get your first name and where you're calling from?
Yeah, my name's Raul. I'm calling from California.
Wow, way in California. What's going on, man? Yeah.
Oh, man. California is wicked, man.
I almost feel sorry for you. I do. But I know there's good people out there. There has to be a lot of good people out there.
Yeah, but it's the politicians, man. You know, I call them Democrats because they're full of crap.
Can I ask you a question? Since you're from California, I've really never talked to anybody out there on the West Coast. Do you see any Trump signs in California right now?
Yeah, I see a lot of flags. You know, like they're on trucks.
Right.
And you know, I see a few signs, but you know, like you were saying, they go in and take the signs.
They steal them. They steal them.
Yeah, exactly. Bunch of freaking thieves, man. You know.
Man, you.
But
oh, I'm sorry.
I see them on trucks.
Okay, that's a good thing. I'm glad you're seeing Trump signs out there. But you seem like you got an accent. Or are you from South or something? Are you from another country?
No, I was born in Texas and raised in here in L.A.
Okay, well, you just got a different accent than we got here in Ohio. We really don't have an accent, but people call me from the East, and I love hearing their accent. I like hearing different accents. You know what I'm saying?
Right. I hear you, man. Well, I just hope that America wakes up. You know, it's like I always say, you know, wake up, America. You know, if you vote for Joe Biden, you know, you're voting for a socialist country.
You're right,
you know,
brother.
Because
you're right.
They have turned. They turned anti-Christ, anti-American, and baby killers. You know,
yes,
I mean,
yes, sir.
So I always say, you know what? Vote all Democrats out of office in 2020.
Man, you know, I just wish there was more people like you out there in California. I really do. I don't know. They may be a lot of people. Maybe they're tired. Maybe you guys are fed up with what's going on right now.
Oh, we're fed up, man. Well, we're fed up, especially with that Governor Newsom. Oh, man.
Wow.
Well, I try to talk to a lot of people and try to convince them vote all these Democrats out of office, man, especially here in California. They're killing us with taxes, man, and then they want to raise them higher, you know?
Wow. Can you tell me, what do you pay out there for, like, a loaf of bread? I mean, how high is things out in California?
For a loaf of bread, it's like $2.78.
So almost $3 for a loaf of bread.
Yeah, $2.78 for a loaf of bread.
I hate to ask you this because I know a lot of people are against smoking right now. I smoke, but what does a pack of cigarettes run out in California?
Oh, I don't know. I don't smoke, man. But from what I see, you know, when I walk in the store, they have signs like there. They're like $5.85 a pack.
Okay.
Almost $6.
That's about like it is here. But tell me again. I mean, give me some more things about what's going on out there. Do you live in a big city in California, or do you live in the country? What?
Yeah, I live in the city. You know, I had an American flag hanging on my car.
Yeah.
And then I realized I was being followed by a black car. He followed me for like I'd say maybe a mile and a half. And then I finally pulled over and got off the car, and he just sat in his car staring at me. And then he made a U-turn and left. So I kind of figured he was following me because I had my American flag in my car.
So,
you know, I had it on my antenna.
So people in California are actually against, some people are actually against the American flag?
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
that's,
definitely.
That's crazy, man. That's crazy because that flag means so much. That represents every man who ever died fighting for our freedoms in this country, man. And I want you to keep fighting out there in California. You tell your friends, man, this has got to stop. And I hope they're listening to you, man.
Hey, I'm a veteran, man. You know, so I fought for my country as a 17-year-old.
Wow.
You know, and I'm still fighting for it. You know.
Well, I want to tell you right now, thank you for your service. Anybody who served in the military, I thank them, and I thank you for your service, sir. Thank you.
Right on, bro. Yeah, you know, and I'm still fighting for it. I'm fighting to keep America free.
Free.
You know, and that's...
You just said it right there. You just said it. The main word is free, brother. We got to keep this country free.
Yeah, if not, it's going to become a socialist country. We cannot allow that to happen.
Well, how hard is it to buy a gun in California right now?
Well, I just went to try and get one, you know, and they gave me all these little red tapes and stuff, so I'm going to go to another store.
Wow.
And try and get me one.
You know, that's awful. The last time California went red, I think, was for Reagan. Reagan, that's been a long time
ago,
man.
Yeah, Reagan, yeah.
You guys need,
exactly.
You and people like you need to take your state back. Make California red again, brother. Make it.
We're trying, bro.
You can do it, man. You can do it.
I'm trying my best, man. I argue with, you know, we go back and forth with people I talk to, you know, but you know, they like, well, I don't like Trump. I said, well, what don't you like about him? Give me one reason why you don't like him. Don't tell me because you hate him, because that's not a reason. Tell me why don't you like him? They can't come up with nothing.
They can't.
I said, so what do you do? I said, so then what do? You're just a follower?
There you go.
What is it?
Yeah, man, you're a great caller. Man, when I do these, I don't know if you follow me or you're my friend on Facebook, but man, go to my Facebook page and follow me on Facebook, please, because man, you're a diamond caller. That's what Maria Dukes just said. You're a diamond caller. I love hearing from people like you. I like hearing from people in different states, and you're the first one that's ever called me from California. And so I'm glad to hear that some people are waking up out there, brother. I'm glad to hear.
Oh,
that.
Man. I'm trying. I've been on that Trump train since day one. Since he said I'm running for president, I got on that Trump train.
Why? I can't understand why so many people out in California. It's a big state. It's a beautiful state. But why do they want to lose their freedoms? I could never understand why. Why do they keep voting these weird Democrats in out there? Like even Nancy Pelosi, she's from California. But they keep
voting them
them in there. Like your governor, Gavin Newsom, yes, he's another, oh my gosh. And you had another one, Brown. Yep. I think your other governor that just left, what was his name? Brown something.
Yeah, Brown. And then, well, you know, the reason people keep voting for them is because they're stuck on super stupid. And you can't fix stupid.
Now, out there in California, do these Democrats, do they try to push people for getting on welfare? Are they trying to give stuff away to make them vote for them out there?
Yeah, exactly. So exactly. You hit the nail on the head.
So they try to keep everybody on the system, right? They want to give away free stuff to keep you voting for Democrats.
Yeah, exactly. And that idiot, I don't know, I'm going to call him an idiot, but
I don't
LeBron
care.
James? LeBron James?
Yes.
He's given thousands and thousands of dollars so that criminals can be able to vote.
He's giving thousands and thousands. I think as long as you're out of jail, you should have a right to vote. But if you're in prison, I don't think you should have a right to vote from a jail cell. No, I don't believe that.
Well, that he's giving money so they can be able to.
Well, sir, I'll tell you what.
It's crazy.
You keep flying your American flag, and I know you will. You sound like the kind of guy that's going to fly your American flag. The heck
people say.
And like you said, you went off and you served this country. Now you're fighting again to try to keep our freedoms. And thank you so much, man. You're a diamond caller.
Hey, thanks for putting your number right there. So, you know, I seen your number and I just said, I'm going to call.
Well, I'm glad you called. And you follow me on Facebook, okay? Do that.
All right.
Follow me. And
okay.
You call me again on my next video because I want to know how things are going in California before this election's over, okay?
Okay.
Anything else you want to say?
Blessed.
You want to, because the mic's open. You want to say something else before you get off here? Come on, man. You're good.
Yeah. All I want to say, man, is go out there and vote for Trump. Keep America a free country.
Yeah.
Because those Democrats have turned anti-Christ, baby killers, anti-cops. And if you vote for Joe Biden, that's a vote for those idiots, all those Democrats.
Yeah,
so
defund the police. That's a real good slogan, ain't it? Defund the police. Really? Give me a break.
Oh, man. Give me a break.
Yeah.
Give me a break on that one, man.
Well, listen,
you know?
Man, God bless you, all right? And thank you for your service to this country. And God bless you. And you call me again, brother.
Hey, man, well, God bless you too, brother. Be blessed.
All right, follow me on Facebook, man. Follow me.
I will.
Thank you.
You have a blessed evening.
All right. All right, man. Great caller. Great caller. I love it when people like him call in. I didn't get his first name. I kind of forget when people tell me things, but great caller. I mean, gosh, you don't get any better than that. Like Sunday night, you guys, I had a call from, what's his name? Mark Hatfield called me Sunday night. And you guys, I don't know if a lot of you out there know Mark Hatfield, but I'll tell you what, Mark's got a big following. And I couldn't believe that Mark Hatfield was actually watching my videos. And I've been watching Mark for a while now. And I was so happy that Mark Hatfield called me last Sunday night. It made my night. And Maria Dukes, you're right. He was a diamond caller, just like Mark Hatfield. I loved it when Hatfield called me. You guys don't watch Mark Hatfield on Facebook, go there and follow him. That guy, I'll tell you what, Mark Hatfield will tell you the truth, and he just flat out tells you how it is, and he don't care. He'll tell you the truth. Kathy, it went by. Carol Neal says, defund the police. Who are you going to call when you need someone? Ghostbusters. Yeah, call the Ghostbusters, but the Ghostbusters don't exist. So, yeah. Susan Haddix says, Mark Hatfield is a great guy. He is, Susan. Mark, I like Mark Hatfield. And I was surprised that he called me. Mark's a good guy. I give Mark two thumbs up. Great patriot. Just like Floyd Croucher there. I mean, I know Floyd don't get around and do live videos and stuff, but if you guys knew this guy right here, Floyd Croucher, this guy, he's a fighter, man. He's a fighter. He's a hard patriot, and I'm sure a lot of you guys are out there. I'm sure most of you are, Julie. What's he say? Steve, I sure hope you're right. Oh, I don't know who you're talking about. Oh, you're referring to somebody else. Okay. Anyway, keep your comments coming. And again, if you want to call, the number's there at the bottom of the comments. Give me a call. I've been going for over an hour now. Maria Duke says, I will follow Mark Hatfield. Follow him. Go on his page. Oh, my God. He does great videos. Mark's got a big beard. I think Mark makes moonshine. I think he actually makes, not moonshine, but whiskey. And, man, he's got a big following. And, yeah, like I said, I got giddy because he called me. And, man, Mark's, gosh, I can't say enough good things about Mark Hatfield. So, he's a patriot. I can't pronounce your name, Sin Fred Jones. Love these videos as a younger generation. I enjoy your videos. I hope I'm not pronouncing your name right. It's S-Y-N-N-E, Sin. I'm sorry, Fred Jones. Thank you for watching my videos. It means a lot to me for you to watch my videos. It does. It means a lot to me. There's Carolyn Hudson. Carolyn's a great, great patriot. She said that she followed Mark Hatfield for 2 years now. He's a great guy. Carolyn, I don't know if you was on here last Sunday night, but Mark Hatfield called in, and he's another diamond caller. Kathy Leedy, Moonshine Mark. Yeah, we got Charles Kyle in here. Again, anybody out there that don't follow me on Facebook, go right to my Facebook page. My name's Donald Whisman. I'm easy to find. My Facebook is open to the public. Go in there and hit that follow button, because I'm not going to stop when these elections over, folks. I'm going to keep on going. I'm going to keep on going. We got a lot of good things coming down the pipe. I'll probably go live from Floyd's event we're having here in Trenton, Ohio. I'll probably go live from there. Carol O'Neill says the only place you can call in and voice your opinion. Yes, you can. That's why I do these videos. I don't do them for me. Now, I used to do videos where I'd do all the talking and I'd read some comments, but yes, I do these videos so you guys can call in and let your voice be heard. And I'll tell you right now, folks, I've said this, but maybe some of you never heard me say it. Silence is consent. And I'll give you a good example about silence being consent. If you're sitting somewhere and eating a donut, all right? I like donuts. I do. I like donuts. Just say you're sitting at a table and you got your donut, right? And some guy comes down and sits next to you. And he reaches over to your plate, and he grabs half your donut, right? And he starts eating it. If you don't say nothing, you basically just let him eat your donut. So silence is consent. If you don't say nothing, go ahead. So speak your voice and be heard. I'm not part of the silent majority. I am outspoken for my support for these Republican candidates, for President Trump. I'm wearing a Lang shirt right now. Great guy. Carolyn Hudson says, yes, just listen when Mark was on. I didn't know he went live. I've been busy volunteering all day. Kathy says, I bet people think it's cold. You call me. I don't know what you mean, Kathy. Maria Dukes, me and Donald Whisman have been friends for 5 years. Yeah, you guys can ask Maria Dukes. I've been doing these videos for a long time. I took a little break there for a while, but I'm back. I'm back in full force. I told you, Maria, I'd be back. Now I'm back. So follow me on Facebook. I know everybody's dropping off. People's probably tired, getting ready to go to bed. I haven't eaten nothing all day, folks. I'm getting hungry. I think I'm going to get me something to eat before I go to bed. I'm going to get up, and I'm going to do it all again tomorrow. I'm going to go out here, and I'm going to fight for President Trump again tomorrow. I'm getting people registered every day, folks. I love it. I love it. We're giving out the Trump signs. People are coming in for the shirts. the hats, and we can't keep the stuff. That's how many people are crazy about President Trump, but it's a good problem to have when you can't keep stuff on the table. I'll take another call here. Take another one more call. Hey, what's up?
Hey, Donald, I wanted to let you know that is 4610 Middletown, Ohio is the actual address.
4610 Middletown, Ohio, and that's the Disabled American Veterans. I know a lot of people on here, Floyd, some people from around here, like one guy called from Franklin. But yes, we will get that. We will get that that event out there. We will let people know, and they will show up, brother. And I'm going to go live from your event, Floyd.
Yes, I want you to do that, Donald, but there's something that I wanted to touch. It's something that you haven't really touched a whole bunch on tonight, is making sure that everybody gets out there and votes as soon as their precincts open up. I mean, as soon as your county place that you can go and vote at, your board of elections, get on out there and vote. And get on out there. Don't wait for election day. Get on out there. Get your voice be heard. Get your vote counted.
Oh, yes. When I first started this video, Floyd, that's the first thing I said is vote early. Vote early. In the state of Ohio, folks, here in the state of Ohio, I know every state's a little bit different, but here you can start voting early about 30 days before the election. And I do know this, Floyd. Some states have already begun early voting. I don't know which ones, but some states have vote early. And like I said, Floyd, earlier, I told everybody, if we all get out here and vote early, well, these states may already be able to pick the winner before the election. So, vote early. Floyd, it's all on you, brother.
Yes. Well, October 6th in Buller County, Ohio is when you can start voting here early. Early voting.
Yes.
I don't know about other states as well as you don't either, because we don't live in them.
No.
But it is very exciting to hear that young man, that Latino young man call in that has served his country from California.
Yes, he was a diamond caller, Floyd. And you're a diamond caller too, brother. You're a diamond caller too, Floyd. Because I know what Floyd Croucher is. Floyd Croucher is a patriot. You are a patriot, Floyd.
Thank you very much, Donald. So are you as well. But like I said, I like to get everybody, go ahead and get out and vote. Go ahead and vote early. Don't wait for the election day to vote. I encourage everybody to vote as soon as they possibly can in their precincts, their counties. I mean, that would be a great thing to go ahead and get it out, get your vote to be counted.
Well, thank you, Floyd. I appreciate you calling me back, man. It's always a pleasure to hear from you, Floyd Croucher. It's a pleasure. You know you're my friend, yeah, brother. I love you, brother.
Donald, I had a time of my life with you up in Vandalia. It was an absolute pleasure and a ball that I had with you.
If everybody out there, Floyd, could have seen a video of you shoving me while pushing this big... I'm a big guy. Like I said earlier, if anybody's new in here, I got very short legs for a big guy. I'm like a gorilla. I got a long back, and Floyd got behind me. I was done. I was going to lay down. I'm like, Floyd, I can't make it. And everybody was dashing to this hangar. Floyd comes running back, gets behind me. I can't do it, but he was shoving my back. I was leaning back, and all I could do was run with my legs. My legs were moving, and all I could do was lean back and breathe. It was funny. You had to be there to see it.
Donald, just like you getting you up there to see President Trump, we are all on the same boat with the same cargo, trying to get that cargo to its destination on time, and that is get President Trump in office.
You're right, brother. We all for the same go, and our local politicians. Don't forget your local politicians, because it's very important, folks. It is. Get your local politicians elected too. Get them elected. Help them.
Yeah, get involved. That's all I can say is get involved, because when you sit back, like you were saying, Donald, let somebody else eat your donut, take your donut. If you don't get involved and do something, and you sit back and you wonder what happened, it's nobody's fault but your own.
You're
There's
right
three different
now.
Type of people in the world. There's people who watch what happened, people who wonder what happened, and people who make things happen. My question to them is, what type of person are they going to be? Are they going to be the person who wondered what happened? Are they going to be the person who watched what happened? Are they going to be people who make things happen? Be a person that makes things happen. Get involved.
get involved. Now, Floyd, how did you like my analogy with the donut? How, I mean, you know I like donuts, Floyd. You know that, okay? I like donuts. But if you do, if you let a man sit down next to you and you don't say nothing, he reaches over and eats your donut, you just basically gave him permission to eat your donut if you don't speak up. So speak out. Well, speak up.
God gave you a brain, and he gave you two eyes, and he gave you a mouth, and he wants you to use it. Not only to breathe with, but he wants you to speak to people. Say something to friends, your neighbors. They say don't talk politics with your friends and neighbors. I disagree with them. This is a very important election. This would be probably the most important election of my lifetime. My family and my friends all know where I stand. My neighbors know where I stand. I drive around town with a truck that's got a billboard in it. If you don't know who I'm voting for, there's something seriously wrong with you.
You're right, Floyd. You're right. But I haven't got anything to eat tonight, Floyd. Actually, I'm getting ready to eat pancakes. I'm going to have some pancakes for supper tonight, okay?
Well, it's not like donuts. You wanted donuts when we came out of the rally when we passed that place.
It's the closest thing I got to donuts tonight. Pancakes is the closest thing I got to donuts. So I'm going to have me some pancakes, folks. I mean, this fat guy is tired. I'm tired, Floyd. And God bless you. Thank you for calling in again. And I want to thank everybody. While you're on the phone, Floyd, I want to thank everybody out there that's watched this video tonight. Steve, thank you for watching. Doyle, the rest of you, Kathy, everybody, thank you, and God bless you. Pray for President Trump. Floyd, you might as well stay on here while I end it. Pray for our president, because the man's carrying a lot of weight on his shoulders right now. The man is. I don't even know how he does it. But pray for him. Pray for our country. And God bless America. Pray for our soldiers, too. Pray for our military, folks. They need it. Pray for our policemen. Pray for our firemen. Pray for the first responders. Like down in Louisville tonight. I don't know what's going to erupt down there. Hello, Billy Berline. Floyd, they're getting ready. They're having protests down in Louisville tonight. Cincinnati, they're having protests.
I'm watching Fox News right now, and they're rioting, they're looting, they're burning the city of Louisville, Kentucky down. It's unreal.
That's terrible. Well, anybody, well, Floyd, I'm going to end this video right here. God bless each and every one of you. And the fat man will be back in a few days with another video. So follow me on Facebook and tune in next time. And Floyd, thank you again for calling.
Trump 2020, baby. Trump 2020.
This fat man signing out. Floyd, thank you, all right?
Thank you, Donald.
All right, bye-bye, Floyd.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street. You're going to take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.